There are only a couple of days left in Peru for the mountaineers, but some of the most strenuous trekking and important research is still ahead of them as they ascend up to 18,600 feet to the weather station atop the largest glacier in the tropics, the Quelccaya Ice Cap.
So here on the summit of Quelccaya, Appalachian State set up a really interesting laboratory of sorts where we come up each year. We record the meteorology with the state-of-the-art weather station that Baker Perry runs, and we're recording all the meteorological conditions throughout the year.
This is the Quelccaya Comprehensive Meteorological Station that's maintained by Appalachian State University in conjunction with the National Meteorology and Hydrology Institute of Peru and the Universidad Nacional de San Antonio de Abad de Cusco, or UNSAC. And it's been in operation since 2014. And Appalachian is the primary institution responsible for installing and managing this comprehensive meteorological station. And so the three instruments at this elevation, in conjunction with the other snow pit work that we're doing, provide a really unique data set to understand what's happening from storm to storm up in these environments.
And we have this robust program, and it's wonderful to see students all around us right now digging snow pits and doing labs and learning the science of how this all fits together.
The trip was brutal. It's probably two and a half hours straight up snow. It was hot, it was cold, it was just kind of weird. It was a straight trudge up, you know. And we were digging snow pits for a snow pit lab. We were analyzing annual snow layers and looking at the crystallization of the actual snowflakes. And we are also looking at the hardness, softness, just general things about each snow layer. But mainly it was a lot of digging.
This project we have up here is a climate change study, but rather than looking forward to the future of climate, we actually look backwards to better understand how climate has changed in the past. It's extremely important in assessing how climate will change is to actually know what the history is. So we're basically establishing the linkage between the meteorology that happens on an hourly basis, and then all the way back to these climate histories that go back thousands of years as preserved in ice cores.
Yeah, so what we're doing here on Quelccaya is a really unique study because we're looking at these layers of snow at a really high resolution, and this is what I'm doing for my graduate thesis at Appalachian State, is I'm trying to relate these layers that we're seeing in the snow on Quelccaya to weather on a daily basis, and that's what's unique about this study. And the reason why that's so important is that that can tell us things about abrupt climate changes, which can happen in month, weekly timescales, and these are the kind of climate changes that are going to have the most detrimental effects to the people who are living here, because we know they've happened in the past, and we know they happen on very short timescales, but we don't know how to say when they're going to happen next, and so that's what we're trying to do here.
Bringing students to a place like this to see the research as it's being done, I think is incredibly informative. I wouldn't be surprised if some of the people here with us today go on and take on careers in global change studies, perhaps motivated by some of the things seen on this trip. And if that's the case, I'd be extremely happy.